Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the 22nd annual commencement ceremonies for Charles Hayes Secondary School. I'm Sandra Jones, and I'm serving you tonight as the Master of Ceremonies. Before we begin, however, there are some housekeeping items that I need to inform you of. First, we ask sincerely that you don't take pictures during the ceremony like you're doing right now, particularly because the flash will interfere with our professional photographers who are taking pictures that will be available to you as early as tomorrow. Second, it's really, really important you don't block the aisles. First, you might hamper the view of the others. Second, there are fire regulations. And you might obstruct a graduate as they are nervously making their way down. And third, most importantly, please ensure that all your cell phones are turned off. I'm going to demonstrate that right now, like this. Thank you very much for your cooperation. So now, the moment we have all been waiting for. Ladies and gentlemen, the graduating class of 2014.
of the world. It's hard to understand what's still yet to unfold. Pretending to be who you're not is a waste of what you got. Keep dreaming, keep dreaming, keep dreaming, keep on, keep believing.
We are the kings and queens, our hearts they break. We may fall in between the cracks. Living life like it's just a game of blackjack. I don't know how, but we always find our way back. Looking back when I was just a little girl with a big dream, living in a lonely world. It seems life is impossible, so believe that you're unstoppable.
Hey, we are the stars and we are open. We are lovers, we are into loving. We are stars and we are open-minded. We are lovers, we are built for loving. Oh, 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 oh. It's hard to see the light when you're caught up in your life. You're scared and insecure, cause now it's fight or flight. Can't think of giving up, you don't know how much you love. Keep dreaming, keep dreaming, keep dreaming, keep on, keep believing.
We are the kings and queens, our hearts they break. We may fall in between the cracks. Living life like it's just a game of blackjack. I don't know how, but we always find our way back. Looking back when I was just a little girl with a big dream, living in a lonely world. It seems life is impossible, so believe that you're unstoppable.
Hey, we are stars and we are open-minded. We are lovers, we are into loving. We are stars and we are open-minded. We are lovers, we are good for loving. Oh, 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 oh.
Reflecting left to fear. So we made our way by finding what was real. Now the days are so long, that summer's moving on.
was just going to say, don't they just look fine? And maybe just a little more applause if you're kind of proud at this very moment. Next, I'd like to introduce three members of the Charles Hayes Secondary School Choir who will lead us in the national anthem. All rise, please, and welcome Dalen Calder, Angel Hoff, and Veronica Robel. Thank you, Dalen, Angel, and Veronica. Audience, you may be seated. Hannah Bryant will now acknowledge the Simpson Nation on their traditional territory and bring congratulations from the Smalley class of 2014.
Why? Negetagotza. Shabetta scan at Hatnis Newsom, Alach Yuba Simpson. Simgigat. Sigram Hnatnach, Lagagi get, Gabba Walksik, Tratni Gabbet Gog at a Negetagotza. Ximadik diwayu, Waps Gilachax diwal haitgu, Gispiwadam git will giot steeds abu, Lacholamps diwal watgu, Zimsian nu. Adzik Sigoru nu will su lauxa Somaliach, Doyach su get in su alightmangu a Somaliach, Dim Gatwinskanu nim su lauxa nilip algagu dim wil wa guatget. Oyaksu will get oidixum, a willu guantis, a will man ach achum, a willu guantisim, a hupo gyawan. Luam goru ma will simni skabu galksa, ach achit a gosh a gyawan. Oyaksit nusum will amuxusum. People of Prince Rupert, on behalf of the Tsimshian Nation, I welcome you to the territory of the Tsimshian. Chiefs, matriarchs, and people of the community, I'm happy to see you all here tonight. My name is Ximadik. I stand in the house of Gilachax. I'm a blackfish from the Gitwogyots tribe, and I am from Lacholamps. I'm proud to be learning the language of Somaliach. Thank you to the people who have taught me Somaliach, and I'm trying hard to continue to learn the language so it will not be lost. Thank you all for being here this evening to celebrate the commencement of the grad class of 2014.
Twaxit noon, Hannah. Second on our speakers list this evening is our principal, Miss Sandy Pond, who brings introductory remarks.
And who needs glasses to see them. I too want to welcome everybody to our 2014 convocation ceremony. Thank you so much for coming and joining us tonight. Graduates, this is a monumental event in your life. It marks the end of an era, the end of your public school experience, and the crossing over into the adult world. Scary. It's a time to be thankful. Thankful to your parents, your guardians, your family, and the friends who have supported and encouraged you, and many of them are here tonight to celebrate with you. It's a time to be thankful to your teachers for the work they have done to help you with your learning and for their guidance and their inspiration. Although we are celebrating tonight, you still have work to do to complete your courses, and don't forget, you still have exams to write, and with the help of your teachers, you will do it, right? Yeah. Stay positive, practice kindness, be thankful, and follow your dreams. I want to extend congratulations from the teachers and staff of Charles Hay Secondary School. Wai wa.
Thank you, Mrs. Pond. Our next guest is our North Coast MLA, Ms. Jennifer Rice.
Thank you. I was just noticing, not besides the footwear, because when you're all wearing Now, I'm not complaining to the organizers of this event, but I do have to share with you how humorous I find this. We just finished the legislative session in Victoria yesterday, so I just got back late last night. And when I got the invitation to attend these ceremonies, and thank you very much for that, this is my first as a first-year MLA, I was really excited. And but my constituent assistant said, "You're invited, but don't say anything, and you're not allowed to talk." And I was like, oh, should I take this personally? But I understand that there's a lot of graduates and it's in the spirit of expediency, so I won't take it too personally, but I just thought that was funny that then today I got a message and she said, "You can speak for a little bit." But I just wanted to just acknowledge that these are the types of events that an MLA loves to attend. They're the best. And personally, high school graduation is it's really special for me because I certainly took a different path. And my brother, who is 10 years younger than me, graduated high school before I did. I actually went to his grad before I went to my own. And it was I was approaching 30 before I even graduated from high school. So I'm really proud of you. This is such an important event. Personally, I've made lots of mistakes in life, and I have very few regrets, but one was that I did not complete high school when the rest of my friends completed high school. So again, I'm really honored to be here, and I'm really happy to celebrate with you. So congratulations again. Thanks.
Thank you, Jennifer. That was actually a test, Jennifer. We're going to score you on that and see if you get invited back. To bring greetings from the City of Prince Rupert, our Mayor, Jack Masalem.
Good evening. To the graduating students, as Mayor and on behalf of Prince Rupert City Council and all of our residents, I offer you our congratulations. You students have achieved a recognized standard that should assist you on your way for the rest of your lives. Please accept our best wishes in your future endeavors. As the economy surges and our community grows, hopefully many of you will find opportunities here. Along with your family and friends, we're proud of your achievements. Personally, I'm proud that you're graduating because we've had a lot of people drop into City Hall today that used to live here, some of them your grandparents and other relatives and friends, and they've dropped in to say hello. So thank you for that. Please, whatever you do, wherever you go, I wish you all the love and happiness a lifetime can bring. My best regards, good luck with your lives. Please make the most of every opportunity you have and make the rest of us, and particularly your family and your friends, proud. All the best.
Thank you, Jack. Representing our Board of Education, Chair Mrs. Tina Last.
Good evening. It's your big day, a day you've been working towards and looking forward to all year. So have we. Thank you for the opportunity, well, parents too, yes. Thank you for the opportunity to speak to you this evening, representing the Board of Education. As the elected officials that govern public education in our community, this is a very big day for us too. We see graduation as the grand prize, the Stanley Cup. This is where we are able to see if the decisions we make at the board table in the best interest of students is working. The goal for us is getting as many of you to this most important milestone, high school completion. This is our test. This is our provincial exam. This is, without question, why we do what we do. It is my privilege to congratulate you on behalf of the board, congratulate your parents and families, and to extend our deepest thanks to all those working within our education system in Prince Rupert that helped you get here today. You did not accomplish this all by yourself. You had a lot of help, and we're grateful for that. Our district is very fortunate to have dedicated employees who work very hard to help you achieve this goal. Finally, as I've done for the last 9 years of commencement ceremonies, I put on my mom hat, and I shamelessly take advantage of your complete focused attention. Good. To all but beg of you, as you go off to celebrate your accomplishment, be safe, take care of yourself, take care of each other, make smart choices and smart decisions. On behalf of Trustees Beal, Gruber, Huddlestone, Kuntz, and Sanchez, our heartfelt congratulations. Thank you.
Thank you, Tina. Next up, Mrs. Sandra Carlick from the Aboriginal Education Council to bring greetings to the grad class.
I was a little bit nervous, but when I saw Hannah Bryant come up here, she did a wonderful job. Lugalam Zebin, Hannah. Honored parents and family, honored teachers, support staff and principals, and especially honored 2014 graduates. I am humbled to be chosen to speak on behalf of the Aboriginal Education Council at this special graduation ceremony. I am here to acknowledge the good work you all have done. Honored parents and family, you are the educational foundation of your child's success. You were their first teacher. You were there to hold their hand on the way to kindergarten on their first day. You were there to make sure they did their homework. You were there to make sure they had a good breakfast. You were there to nurture and encourage them when they wanted to give up. You were there to fill their buckets with kindness and love. All of what you've done may seem like small things, but to your children, it means a lot. They would not have come to this milestone without you. Tonight, to witness your son, daughter, receive a grade 12 graduation certificate echoes loudly that you all have done a good job. Lugal Am Jepsum. To honor teachers, support staff, and principals, you have to give yourself a pat on the back for your dedication and relentlessness to the students. Teaching and giving support is challenging, but more so very rewarding. To see these young men and women all dressed up with gleaming pride on their faces is evident that you all were part of their success. Doeksik Newsom. Now to the graduates. As you were growing up, year after year, you received words of wisdom from elders, parents, support staff, teachers, and principals. Now your responsibility to go out Now it is your responsibility to go out and make wise choices. To the Aboriginal graduates, the Aboriginal Education Council is hopeful that you never forget your traditional identity. Hagwal Yan, walk slow, take your time, and think things through. Ajiksagagodam, we are proud of each and every one of you. As you journey on to your next milestone, Saam Jawan at Agilks Aminiskin, do your best and take care of yourself. Congratulations.
Lugalam, Sandra. Twixit noon. Last but not least, for your listening pleasure tonight, is the guest speaker. I'm happy to welcome Miss Sheila Wells.
Just give me a minute to get organized. You didn't see that already, did you? Okay. You guys look great. Absolutely fantastic. Special guests, community members, Charles Hayes staff, parents, and the graduating class of 2014. It is with honor and great pleasure and a feeling of belonging that has me standing here tonight. Your request of me to share some of the successes, trials and tribulations, and the importance of the journey I've experienced through my roles as a teacher, a coach, a counselor, and a principal, coupled with my passionate commitment to education, could take days. But I will share the Coles Notes version. Part of my message is encrypted within the stories I'm about to tell you. Last September brought new challenges for me as I was transferred to an elementary school. Feeling completely out of my comfort zone, I embarked on this new journey with total commitment and energy, knowing that it was a sink or swim situation. The unknown caused me many restless nights and high anxiety, but for me, failure was not an option. I was given the gopher jobs, delivering books to classrooms, moving paper,
greeting parents, picking up garbage. I completed all the assigned tasks, and I tried to keep out of everybody's way. But I watched, and I listened. Before you know it was the end of September and time for the Terry Fox run, I was given the task of standing at the finish line. Now, seriously, how can you screw that up? Well, let me tell you. In fact, in my mind, I was going to multitask, and I was going to make a mental note of all the fast runners that came in first, because I was going to recruit them for the cross-country team. I'd heard about the cross-country team on the PA. So I'm feeling like I'm finally pretty proud of myself here. So the kids start crossing the finish line, and they're all gathering around me. I was really beginning to feel like I belonged. And I'm chatting with the kids, and then one of the older kids says to me, "Where are our freezies?" I said, "Freezies?" And the kids said, "Mrs. Cobbs always gives us freezies after the Terry Fox run." You know, and then some of the younger kids start crying, and I'm like, OMG, I blew it. But of course, Mrs. Levelton and the secretaries bailed me out by buying and delivering popsicles to all the classes. Now, I know that many of you would like to have lots of money, buy all the toys you want, and work as little as possible, right? Okay. So first, what I'd like to ask you to do is, at some point in the next 6 months, buy the book, The Wealthy Barber, or The Wealthy Barber Returns. It's very good advice. Read it years ago, and I've reread it a couple times. This is a key to your success. So let me tell you a little about what I learned about this year and two ways to become a millionaire. Most of you know that at high school, I didn't deal with puke or number two. Well, for the record, I still don't. But even bigger at elementary school is snot. I arrive at school every morning, freshly showered, clean clothes, and then my morning slowly deteriorates. First, you see the kid picking their nose. Then, they wipe their arms across their face, snot from ear to ear. And then, just as the snot's like migrating over their lip, out comes their tongue, and they lick it. Then the next thing I know, they're giving me a hug. 30 minutes later, I have dried, crusty, whitish matter all over my pants. As Mr. Dalton would say, Judas Priest, what I said? As you know, well, and you do know what the worst part of this all is? You and I were no different at that age. You might be wondering why I told you this story. It's plain and simple. One of you could become an instant millionaire. If you were to invent a device or a type of Kleenex with extracting power that could remove snot without the kid knowing, it would be an extraordinary day. Not only would you become an instant millionaire, but you would have lots of happy parents. And if you're thinking about having kids, come and spend a week with me at elementary school. Because I bet you didn't learn about snot as a form of birth control in your sex ed classes. Okay, the second way to become a millionaire is even easier. Sponges and Ziploc bags. First, you take a sponge. Then you dip it in water. Then you put it in a plastic bag and seal the bag, and then you freeze it. Okay, remember that. Now, every time I turned around, a kid was crying and asking for an ice pack. These are really easy to use. Most of the time, I couldn't see a scratch on the kid, even though they'd fallen. They were always hurting, and they kept crying and saying, "It hurts, it hurts." The secretaries would give the kid a sponge, and they'd be better in 5 minutes. This drove me absolutely crazy, because 90% of the time there's nothing wrong with them. But they needed a little nurturing. Now, I don't want you to start thinking that I'm turning soft in middle age. I look at it as adapting to the situation, being flexible, and taking the fastest path to have the kids stop crying. So come up with a catchy name for a frozen sponge in water and start selling it to parents, schools, and daycares. After you make your first million, I'll take a 5% royalty. So what are some words of wisdom I can say to you tonight that could make a profound difference in your life? To me, the biggest impact and the biggest commitment you can make about learning is to get to know yourself and be yourself. Learn about who you are. What are your values? What are your beliefs? And what are your morals? Be realistic when setting your goals. Aim high and push yourself to work outside your comfort zone. Don't settle for less than the best. Build relationships on respect, fairness, trust, and honesty. Be compassionate and tolerant of all people. Never, never, never make a promise you can't or have no intentions of keeping. In fact, you know I rarely make a promise. It's easier for me to say, I'll try. Sometimes life isn't fair. You don't get 4 or 5 chances in the real world, so give it your best try on the first shot. Know your weaknesses and know your strengths and build on them. But remember, nobody is perfect. On your learning journey, do not burn bridges. Be true to yourself. If you believe in yourself, you can achieve. Take responsibility for your behavior, your actions, and your decisions, whether you succeed or not. Be passionate. Know when to work and know when to play. Don't be afraid to share who you are with others. Lastly, to me, it's all about integrity. Don't pretend to be somebody you're not. Ask yourself if you're in control, or are you merely a puppet controlled by others and following others? Integrity is vital. If you are true to your beliefs, work hard, are honest and respectful, then you can hold your head high at the end of each and every day. Know yourself and be proud of yourself and stay true to yourself. Others will notice. Congratulations, grads, on your successes so far, and best wishes in your future endeavors.
I have so many visuals after that. Thanks so much, Sheila. Now it's the moment we've been waiting for, when each graduate comes forward to share a little moment in the spotlight. At this juncture, 4 more staff members will join me on stage. Principal Pond, Vice Principal Rourke, Vice Principal Leach, and ex-Vice Principal, now Principal at the middle school, Ken Minette. Mrs. Pond and Mrs. Rourke will present diplomas to the students and move the tassels from right to left to signify the students' graduation. Mr. Leach and Mr. Minette will read biographies of each student as they accept their diplomas. As with all great productions, this whole process could not have been accomplished without the generosity and support of the community. Tonight, many students will be the recipients of scholarships and bursaries from the community. The total monetary value of today's awards is more than $111,000. Since our first Charles Hayes graduation ceremony, well over $750,000 has been handed out. Our sincere thanks go out to those people, those businesses and organizations that have invested in the future by financially supporting our students. I'd like to acknowledge the members of our community who have also given of their time this evening to represent the various benefactors and to present awards and bursaries. On behalf of the grads, I thank you all. And now, to Mr. Leach and Mr. Minette.
Oops. That's Miss Jones. Here we go. Kimberly Axidan. Kim says that art alone stole her heart, and her school trip to Ottawa to present the Grizzly Bear Box of Hope last year was a crowning achievement. She hopes to work at Overweighty, travel extensively, go to Alberta, and eventually become a makeup artist. Kim thanks her parents for helping her to get here today.
Kyle Alexey. Kyle's courses of choice have been physical education and metal shop. He's been a valued Rainmakers basketball team member. And although his future plans are as of yet unknown, Kyle would like to thank his parents, his sister Leanne, Mr. Saka, and Mr. Bishop for their guidance and support.
Kevin Anderson. Kevin's course, Foci, zeroed in on metalwork and phys ed. He enjoyed work experience placements at the Fire Hall and Broadwater Industries. Kevin's future plans include attending BCIT's pipe fitting program, continued work at Saanich Plumbing, and possibly a trip to Bora Bora. He thanks his parents for being there for him. From Tracy Haldane, he receives a QP Local 105 bursary.
Charlie Ann Andrews. Figure skating and science are Charlie Ann's fields of interest. She intends more work in the sciences at Northwest Community College and then a nursing career. Charlie Ann is receiving a Grain Workers Union Local 333 bursary from Hubert Haldane and a Prince Rupert Grain Scholarship presented by Bruce Grant. She thanks her parents for supporting her through high school and helping to set her future in place.
Madeline Angus. Maddie has enjoyed listening to many of the motivational speakers who have come to the school. She also was impressed by the work being done at the Port Authority during her work experience time there. Maddie plans to attend NWCC to study criminology and tonight receives a TD Canada Trust bursary from Fat Tran, as well as the Gangolix Education Department Award from Claude Barton and the Polyco Rupert Square Award from Stephen Tao.
Norma Apollos. Norma's interests lie in the humanities. She has captained both the girls' volleyball and soccer teams. This fall, we'll see Norma taking up a position at the University of Toronto, where she will begin studies towards becoming a criminal lawyer. Emile Tomescu is presenting Norma with the Michael Tomescu Memorial Award, and she receives an award from the Royal Canadian Mounted Police Honor Guard member, the Prince Rupert Grain Scholarship, and the Prince Rupert Lawyers Bursary from Bruce Grant.
Avery Bailey. Avery's interests are playing soccer and running. He also did a fabulous job of carving a bear sculpture in wood shop, for which Miss Linseth was infinitely proud. Initially, Avery would like to find a position working for the city to fund his dream of a welding ticket at NWCC and pursuing coursework at the Vancouver University of Art and Design using those welding skills. Avery would love to see Athens and may end up in Prince Rupert or one of the Prairie Provinces. He thanks his family for all they've done for him.
Austin Bainan. Austin is renowned as a cheerful figure in the front entrance of our school. He enjoys sports and art, and after graduation would like to attend Heckett Strait with the eventual goal of going to college and pursuing a career in the trades. Austin would like to thank his grandparents and Mrs. Leach for never giving up on him.
Kelsey Brown. Kelsey loved her chemistry and foods classes and volunteered at the Children's Festival and Northern Health Kindergarten Fair. She plans to attend Northwest Community College to begin training as a registered nurse and later continue on at UNBC. Tonight, Kelsey is receiving the Prince Rupert Environmental Award from our MLA, Jennifer Rice. Ms. Hornsby commented this afternoon that people often talk about being environmentally conscious, but noted that Kelsey lives her environmental commitment each and every day.
Sarah Brown. Sarah saw Math 11 with Mrs. Saka and Art 12 with Mrs. Parker as highlights at CHSS. She hopes to attend Vancouver Island University and squeeze in a trip to Greece somewhere along the way. Sarah thanks her parents, grandparents, and her awesome teachers for believing in her.
Sam Brunel. Sam was interested in biology, photography, and certified PE, participating on the basketball and cross-country teams. Sam's immediate plans are to take a year and travel through Europe. As for what happens after that, he's playing his cards close to his chest.
Hannah Bryant. Hannah is primarily a student of the sciences with a passion for chemistry, but has been very active in student leadership at CHSS as well. This fall, she'll be attending Middlebury College in Vermont with the long-term goal of becoming a pediatrician. Mrs. Jeffrey and Karen Jeffrey are presenting Hannah with the George William Jeffrey Memorial Scholarship. Michelle Bryant is presenting a Ridley Terminals Incorporated Bernard W. Willers Memorial Scholarship. Charlene Hamilton presents a Women of the Moose Bursary, and from Bruce Grant, a Prince Rupert Grain Scholarship.
Katie Buell. Katie chose to focus primarily on the sciences, although she worked as a crew member for the school musicals and drama fest and was a member of the Rainmakers soccer team. Katie plans to pursue a career as a marine biologist and will attend the University of Victoria. Michelle Bryant is presenting a Ridley Terminals Incorporated bursary, and she also receives a Melvin Martin Holkestad Memorial Bursary.
Emma Burton. A French immersion student, Emma enjoyed field trips to Quebec and Montreal with her class. She also went to school abroad for a semester. Although her future plans remain undecided, she plans to eventually attend college, but would also like to travel the world.
Miguel Cachero. Physics and chemistry have been Miguel's chosen fields. He also has participated on the school volleyball and soccer teams. His immediate future holds plans to travel the South America before choosing a career direction. Miguel receives the Chris Batko Memorial Bursary and the Luso Portuguese Award from Alice Pereira. He thanks his parents, grandparents, family, and Victor Menzies for supporting him.
Hannah Cam. Hannah is also a French immersion student. She intends to make a career in dancing and hopes to do that on cruise ships so she can see the world. From Karen Fate, Hannah receives the Canadian Parents of French Bursary. From Elia Bishia, a Filipino Association Award. From Paul Rajendram, a Knights of Columbus Council 5282 Award. From Julie Stevens, a Lady of the Royal Purple Award. A QP Local 105 bursary from Tracy Haldane. And a bursary from the Hospital Employees Union from Sarah Fontaine.
River Carr Woods. River is a proud rainmaker who participated in both basketball and track and field. Her main areas of interest at CHSS were physical education and the sciences. Future plans include attending the University of Calgary's Faculty of Veterinary Medicine and backpacking through Europe. River would like to recognize her family, in particular her sisters, Kate and Ivy, for supporting her.
Kelsey Cassavant. Kelsey's interests lie in the performing arts. She would like to pursue a career in either acting or screenwriting. Her future plans are to audition for multiple theater schools while working to secure some funds. Tonight, she's receiving the Charles Hayes Director's Choice Award.
Riley Collins. Riley has enjoyed learning about both chemistry and photography. She would like to attend Thompson Rivers University and train to become a medical lab technician. She would also like to travel the great wide world in search of adventure.
Julia Kuna. Outside of her school commitments, Julia has been involved extensively in dance. Her immediate plans are to attend Northwest Community College, followed by coursework at Thompson River University to become a kindergarten teacher.
Tamara Daw. Tamara enjoyed her time in geology, English, and working on the yearbook. Her plans include attending the College of New Caledonia and UNBC, studying psychology, journalism, and criminology. Tamara is receiving the Roger Obata Achievement Award.
Akash Deol. Akash has variously studied math, the sciences, and metal shop. He enjoyed participating in the Terrace Trades Fair and participated in volleyball, soccer, and rugby. Future plans are to attend BCIT in a program yet to be named.
Alicia Dudeward. Alicia's preferred courses were family studies and certified PE. She participated in the school production of Chicago. Now Alicia intends to attend NWCC to pursue a career in early childhood education.
Garrett Duffus. Garrett's courses of choice were physics and chemistry. He enjoyed the kayaking trip to McNichol with the certified PE class. Garrett is pursuing a career as an electrician. Joe Didichuk is presenting Garrett with a Prince Rupert Elks Lodge No. 342 Memorial Bursary. And he also receives an award from QP Local 105 from Tracy Haldane.
Sasha Enns. Sasha is a rugby enthusiast. He looks forward to attending Northwest Community College in Terrace in order to become a heavy equipment operator. Tonight, Sasha receives the Frank Amonte Memorial Bursary and a Mayor Terminals Holding Corporation Scholarship from Andy Enns.
Caitlin Fontaine. Caitlin's interest in the sciences will see her attend the College of New Caledonia and UNBC to become a registered nurse. Caitlin is receiving a Hospital Employees Union Award from Sarah Fontaine, a Prince Rupert Regional Hospital Auxiliary Bursary from Sharon Pavala, a Prince Rupert Rotary Club Academic Scholarship, the Loyal Order of the Moose William Bagshaw Award, and a Shoppers Drug Mart Award from Randy Younghusband.
Celine Foote. Celine's plans are presently in flux, but likely will include performance art or psychology. She would like to thank her parents for still admitting she's their child and for all their support.
Matthew Forrest. Both the wood and metal shops were Matt's favorite haunts at CHSS. His community involvement included archery and hockey, as well as participating in our work experience program. He enjoyed his time at the Port of Prince Rupert and the Western Canada Marine Response Corporation. Short term, Matt will continue with his current job and perhaps explore commercial fishing. For the future, he hopes to attain a heavy-duty mechanic or electrical ticket and use the proceeds to visit Thailand. Matt thanks his mom and his girlfriend for their support.
Alexandra Frizzell. Alex focused her efforts on art and family studies this year. She sees herself traveling the foothills of Alberta while continuing with employment at Overweighty. Alex thanks her parents for being there throughout her school career.
Sophia Famonte. Sophia's subjects of interest were photography and family studies. She would like a career in physiotherapy or fitness and nutrition and hopes to make travel part of her lifestyle.
Jeevan Gill. Jeevan has been a student of the sciences but also has a fondness for concert and jazz band. He enjoyed participating in the music festivals in Sun Peaks and Whistler. Currently, he plans to become a veterinarian and will begin studies at Northwest Community College. Tonight, he receives the Ridley Island Terminal Scholarship from Michelle Bryant.
Thomas Gould. This French immersion student had a bent for hands-on coursework and enjoyed metal and wood shop classes, culminating in his entrance to our ACET welding program. A highlight for Thomas was the grade 11 trip to Quebec. Future plans are to attend Holland College in PEI and study underwater welding. You may see Thomas running a sea urchin diving business or working for Adams Diving and Marine Services. Either way, you'll likely find Thomas immersed in water. He thanks his mom and dad for their support.
Aaron Grant. Aaron was a participant in the school musicals all through high school. He enjoyed the trip to Europe this spring, particularly aspects of Greece. This fall should see Aaron at UNBC beginning his studies in psychology. Aaron is being presented with a PAC-10 tutoring award by Chris Thompson, and also receives a Polyco Rupert Square Award from Stephen Tao and the Prince Rupert Grain Scholarship from Bruce Grant.
Tyler Green. Tyler has a quiet disposition, but was not shy in his expression of just how much he enjoyed being a world traveler as part of the school group that visited Europe this year. It was a rewarding experience and one that he will always remember fondly. Tyler would like to thank his mom for her support and Mrs. Leach and Mr. Russell for providing this valuable learning opportunity for him.
Brandon Gregory. Brandon is known for his great sense of humor. He recently completed the Skills Link program at Heckett Strait, where he achieved a number of certificates that will support him in the world of work. Brandon would now like to upgrade and attend college. He thanks his parents and Mrs. Leach for driving him to succeed.
Riley Griffin. Riley's interests have been in math and the sciences. He was part of the Charles Hayes curling team. Future plans have Riley attending Northwest Community College or the College of New Caledonia as he embarks on a path leading to either the Army or becoming an X-ray technician. He would like to thank his mom for being the source of his motivation.
Selena Gadanye. Selena was a valued member of many teams at the school and renowned for her unbridled enthusiasm and perkiness in general. She took part in the trip to Vimy Ridge and also spent time in Brazil on a Rotary Youth Exchange. She will be studying sports and recreation at Vancouver Island University. Paul Ranjandram is presenting her with the Knights of Columbus Council 5282 Award. Jennifer Rutens Hernandez is presenting a Prince Rupert Special Events Society Award. Hazel Bott is presenting for Royal Canadian Legion Branch number 27. Colleen Weens for School District 52 support staff. And she also receives an award from the Loyal Order of the Moose from Randy Younghusband.
Joshua Hagstrom. Josh has been active in the local Sea Cadet program and worked behind the scenes on the school musical. He would like to attend Northwest Community College and later study divinity to become a minister in the Anglican Church of Canada. Terry St. Louis is presenting Josh with an award on behalf of the Royal Canadian Legion Branch 27 Ladies Auxiliary, and he also receives the Prince Rupert Ministerial Association Award from David Sterling.
Nathan Haldane. Nathan envisions himself as an investment banker. He plans to attend NWCC in order to fulfill that goal. From Lori Wilson, he receives a Canadian Fishing Company Award. From Grant, from Hubert Haldane, a Grain Workers Union Local 333 bursary, a QP Local 105 Award from Tracy Haldane, and a Prince Rupert Grain Scholarship from Bruce Grant.
Jonathan Hansen. Jonathan can be described as having lots of energy. Jonathan channels this energy into his passion for art and skateboarding. His future goals are oriented towards pursuing a career in the trades. Jonathan recognizes his family for all their support.
Shelby Hansen. Music and the sciences captured Shelby's spirit at CHSS. She fondly recalls the Quebec trip in grade 10 where she visited Montreal and Quebec City. Shelby intends to take courses at NWCC, followed by Vancouver Island University to receive training as an ultrasound technician. Colleen Weens is presenting an award from School District 52 support staff. Shelby recognizes her mom, Carmen, who has supported her through thick and thin.
Zoe Helfers. Zoe has followed interests in both drama and the sciences. She participated on the soccer team and also in school musicals. She would like to pursue a career in nursing. Dr. Barlow is presenting Zoe with a Cayan Island Optometry Bursary, an award from Galaxy Garden Restaurant, and the Belford Stafford Memorial Bursary.
Christopher Jodwin. Christopher's area of interest has been physics. He is working towards his electrician certification through Northwest Community College. He would like to thank his parents, his teachers, and counselors. Chris is receiving a Prince Rupert Port Authority bursary from Michael Gurney, Manager of Corporate Communications.
Autumn Rain Johansson. Autumn Rain expressed an affinity for biology, chemistry, and English. She plans on attending UBC Okanagan for a bachelor's degree in science as a foundation for a career in psychology. Colleen Weens is presenting Autumn with an award from School District 52 support staff, and she also receives a Mar Terminals Holding Corporation scholarship from Andy Enns. Autumn would like to thank her parents for their love and guidance.
Kieran Kirkbright. Kieran is an active outdoorsman who is following a career in the Millwright program through ACET. He will continue certification training and then follow the work. Kieran would like to thank Mr. Strand for helping him get all his assignments completed. Terry St. Louis is presenting Kieran with an award from the Royal Canadian Legion Branch 27 Ladies Auxiliary, and Jeff Carlson is presenting a bursary from the Prince Rupert Lions Club.
Kyla Knott. Kyla's favorite subjects were family studies and biology, and she participated in the Work Experience Program. Kyla would like to attend UBC and begin studies in business administration. She thanks her mom, Mrs. Offit, and Mrs. Hornsby for offering support and encouragement. Kathy Quain is presenting Kyla with a Grad Parent Committee bursary.
Garrett Cobza. Geography and Earth Science are courses that stand out for Garrett. He played on the Rainmakers volleyball and basketball teams. Although he hasn't indicated a program, Garrett's plans include attending Camosun College in Victoria. Karen Fate is presenting Garrett with an award on behalf of the Canadian Parents for French. He also receives the Prince Rupert Department of Fisheries Dean Miller Memorial Award from Stan Kish.
Jake Comedina. Jake returned to Charles Hayes from Kelowna for his grade 12 year. He enjoyed courses in earth science, metal shop, and participated in the ACET electrical program. He will continue with Northwest Community College and thanks his friends and family for their support.
Marcus Comedina. Marcus, a.k.a. Funky Comedina, is also in the ACET electrical program and was a member of the Rainmakers basketball squad. He plans to continue his training through NWCC and would like to thank his parents and teachers for helping him through school. Larry Hope is presenting Marcus with the Northern Savings Credit Union George Virick Memorial Bursary.
Kyle Corpy. Kyle did his work experience at Entire Automotive. He plans to get his Class 5 ticket and seek work in the oil fields of Alberta.
Alexander Lewis. Alex has fond memories of drama and being on the school's rugby team. He plans to do some preliminary coursework at NWCC before transferring to UNBC on his way to becoming a science teacher, maybe a science and drama teacher. Hope we'll see you back here someday. Alex thanks his parents for being his rock.
Jasmine Lindquist. Jasmine indicates chemistry is a major subject of interest. Without specifying an end goal, she plans to attend the College of New Caledonia and then UNBC. Jasmine would like to thank her parents for their support. Tonight, she receives the French Post Association RWK Elliott Award and a CHSS Parent Advisory Committee bursary from Belvinder Nanan.
Jeremiah McMunn. JJ enjoyed classes in art and physical education. He participated in the work experience program and was able to gain some insight into the operations at the port. He would like to work at the port for a while and then continue his education at Northwest Community College. He thanks many of the people at Charles Hayes who have supported him.
Sean Martin. Very enthusiastic. Sean's immediate plans are to stay in Prince Rupert for a bit and then go to either Calgary or Vancouver to further his education. He would like to attend SAIT or BCIT for programming and graphics courses on the way to becoming a video game developer.
Hannah McCarter. Hannah's preferred courses were chemistry, biology, and photography. She has been involved with the student leadership group and the MeetAwe activities. From Colleen Ween, she received a School District 52 Support Staff Award. From Terry St. Louis, a Royal Canadian Legion Branch No. 27 Ladies Auxiliary Award. And from Andre Michaud, an award from the Prince Rupert Administrators Association.
Sarah McChesney. Sarah has been a valued member of the Rainmakers basketball team at Charles Hayes. She will attend Thompson Rivers University this fall towards a degree in education while continuing as a competitive swimmer on their varsity team. Tanya Carter is presenting Sarah with the Connor Carter Memorial Bursary and an award from the Prince Rupert District Teachers Union.
Denise McLean. Denise has been interested in science and languages and was involved in the band program throughout high school. She would like to begin her post-secondary education at NWCC and then transfer to UBC or UNBC to study nursery.
Corey McSorley. Corey indicates physics and phys ed as courses of interest. He played volleyball for the school and participated in track and field. Corey would like to pursue nautical sciences at BCIT and hopes for a career in the marine transportation industry. He is a recipient of a Melvin Martin Hokestad Memorial Bursary and the Prince Rupert Minor Hockey Association Award.
Riley Miller. Math and sciences are Riley's preferred courses. He participated on the rugby team and Kaijudo Club. Either BCIT or NWCC will see Riley following his career direction in the electrical program. Riley receives a Prince Rupert.
Saul is a recipient of a Royal Canadian Legion Branch 27 Award presented by Hazel Bott and a TD Canada Trust Bursary presented by Fat Tran. He thanks his family for their support both in and out of school.
Nolan Ryan. The ACET Millwright program cemented Nolan's interest in the trades. He plans to continue along this career path, perhaps adding a secondary welding ticket to his repertoire along the way. He sees California in his travel plans. Thanks to Mom, Grandpa, and Grandma for getting him here today.
John Sampson. Art, law, and PE interested John. He was a valued member of the Rainmakers basketball and volleyball teams. He enjoyed his work experience placements and hopes to head to Camosun College for further education. Tonight, John receives the All-Native Tournament Jim Ciccone Memorial Award from Joe Spencer, a Canadian Fishing Company bursary from Lori Wilson, and an Aboriginal Education Scholarship from Debbie Layton Stevens.
Sarah Sampson. Sarah's interests lie in science and medicine. She plans on first-year college courses, then on to Thompson River University. Christine Comedina is presenting Sarah with a Grad Parent Committee bursary, Dr. Barlow, the Cayenne Island Optometry Bursary, and from Debbie Layton Stevens, an Aboriginal Education Scholarship.
Jasjot Sandhu. Jasjot enjoyed his time playing various sports at Charles Hayes and now intends to further hone his skills to become a millwright. Jasjot is receiving a Healthy Choices bursary from Bill Parmar.
Jesse Schaefer. An enthusiastic soccer and rugby player, Jesse has been part of the ACE at Millwright program. He plans to stay in Ripon and attend Northwest Community College to complete his Millwright training. Julie Stevens is presenting Jesse with an award from the Ladies of the Royal Purple. He also receives the Woman of the Moose Award from Charlene Hamilton and the Loyal Order of the Moose Paul O'Krantz Bursary from Randy Younghusband.
Jasmine Sikhan. A science and math student, Jasmine played on the volleyball, basketball, and soccer teams. She'll be attending school in Vancouver to study business. Nadia Movold is presenting Jasmine with a Royal LePage Prince Rupert Bursary.
Sukraj Sikhan. Sukraj enjoyed our metal and wood shops and plans to study engineering at NWCC and travel the world at some point. He would like to thank his teachers, family, and parents. He receives an Indo-Canadian Sikh Association bursary from Balvinder Nenon.
Akash Sharma. Earth science was a course that Akash particularly enjoyed. He also took part in the work experience program. Akash now plans to upgrade his math and science courses and would eventually like to relocate to Vancouver.
Manisha Sharma. Marketing, the sciences, and fine arts all interested Manisha. She is a constant volunteer for community activities such as SeaFest, Halloween Fest, and other events. Manisha will study economics at SFU this fall. She is the recipient of the Arthur Munger Memorial Bursary, presented by Andre Michaud, a Healthy Choices Bursary, and an award from Joe Hall and Associates Certified General Accountants, presented by Bill Parmar.
Jay Shaw. Jay was drawn to art and PE, but outside of that is elusive about future plans. He may see two roads that diverge in the wood and plans taking the one less traveled. Europe is on his list of travel plans. Jay makes no secret of telling his family, older sister Atara and brother Stevie, how much he appreciates their support.
Amrit Sidhu. Without specifying a field of study, Amrit indicated that he will pursue courses at NWCC and later go on to university. He plans to continue working and hopes to travel. This evening, Amrit receives a Fran Tanaka bursary. He would like to thank his parents.
Rika Silab. Rika's preferred courses were art and chemistry. She would like to follow this by beginning studies in forensic science and tossing in the odd trip to Europe. She would like to thank her family and friends. Elia Bisia is presenting Rika with a Filipino Association bursary.
Cyrus Sobretto. The BC Youth Parliament, drawing, photography, drama, and musical theater have had to balance with the sciences in Cyrus's life. Cyrus plans to study pharmacy at UVic and tonight receives a Filipino Association Award from Ellie Abicia, a Hospital Employees Union Award from Sarah Fontaine, a Knights of Columbus Council 5282 Award from Paul Rajendram, from Julie Stevens, a Ladies of the Royal Purple Award from Amy Dobson, a PAC-10 Tutoring Award, and a Prince Rupert Administrators Association Award from Andre Michaud.
Travis Stenset. Demos and explosions in science class are memories that Travis will treasure from Charles Hayes. His work experience at McCarthy GM cemented his love for the Duramax and served to focus career goals on being a mechanic. In the future, Travis may be found traipsing around Australia. He thanks his parents and the staff who supported him at Charles Hayes.
Journey Stevens. Journey takes pride in her enjoyment of sport and fitness and plans to attend Northwest Community College studying both criminology and psychology. She has travel plans for California and New York before or after obtaining full-time employment. Journey thanks her parents and grandparents for supporting her.
Jason Stewart. Jason leans towards the business world, having focused on accounting and infotech during his senior year. While not definite about attending Northwest Community College, he plans to be working in the near future as a way of funding his dreams.
Andrew Stewart. Science and tech, media arts, Subway, and Good Times Electronics all receive a thumbs up in Andrew's world. He enjoyed his stint on our junior boys basketball team. A movie video diploma at the Vancouver Art Institute factors into Andrew's future plans. Tonight, Andrew receives a CHSS Parent Advisory Committee bursary from Balvinder Nanan. He thanks his parents and sister for their support.
Jeremy Stewart. From the fine arts to phys ed, Jeremy has immersed himself in a multiplicity of courses, including the Work Experience Program. He envisions beginning courses in the culinary arts at Vancouver Community College and thanks his mother for her support. Jeremy is being presented with a Quadra Travel bursary.
Kirkland Stroud. Kirkland's interests include curling and photography. After taking a year off, he plans to apply to BCIT for some computer courses in support of a hospitality and tourism degree. Kirkland felt his parents should be recognized for the love and support they have given him over the years.
Billy Swanson. Chemistry, biology, and band occupied Billy during her senior year. She participated in the trip to Europe this spring and also enjoyed band trips to Whistler and Sun Peaks. Her immediate plans are to save up money to go to university. To help her, she's receiving a Kayan Island optometry bursary from Dr. Barlow, a Prince Rupert Regional Hospital auxiliary bursary, and a Prince Rupert Rotary Club academic scholarship from Sharon Pavila.
Kate Tattersall. Kate is enthused with the performing arts and certified PE. Current plans are to attend the Art Institute of Vancouver to study interior design and marketing. She would like to thank her family for their support.
Kennedy Thorson. A French immersion student, Kennedy has been a fixture in the band and choir groups. Thompson Rivers University welcomes Kennedy into their fine arts program to continue her photography studies. Karen Fate is presenting a Canadian Parents for French Award. Kennedy also receives a Charles Hayes Parent Advisory Committee Award from Belvinder Nanan.
McGee Tomlinson. McGee has balanced physics and chemistry with history and English. She played soccer and helped with the backstage crew on the school musical. She would like to attend UBC where she plans to study engineering. McGee receives both a Maureen McLean and Lothar Kinnar bursary and an award from the Prince Rupert Rotary Club.
Trong Tran. Trong participated on the volleyball, soccer, and track and field teams. His goal is a career in architectural design, which he hopes to begin at Humber College in Toronto. Trong is the recipient of awards from the Charles Hayes Parent Advisory Committee and the Prince Rupert Rotary Club presented by Belvinder Nanan. He offers special thanks to the staff and students who have helped him and his parents, aunt, and uncle for giving him this opportunity to go to school in Prince Rupert.
Skylar Tuba. Skylar is a student for whom fine arts, chemistry, programming, and rugger are central to his school experience. Musicals and Drama Fest were additional highlights at CHSS. He also enjoyed volunteering at the Lester Center. Future plans include physics and engineering, probably at UVic. Australia and Europe are options in his travel plans. Skylar thanks Mrs. O'Toole, his mom, dad, and stepmom for being his guiding lights.
Christopher Vanderweel. Chris names math and physics as subjects of interest. As one of our ACE industrial electrical students, he plans to continue training in his field at Northwest Community College, but is also considering welding. Chris is staying in the area to find work and may venture overseas on occasion. He would like to thank his parents and all his supportive family.
Hunter Vanier. Hunter has a natural passion for all things related to shops, tools, and welding, so the ACET welding program was a perfect fit. Minor hockey, snowmobiling, dirt biking, camping, and becoming a fishing guide are all memorable facets of his life. In the future, Hunter plans to test his survival abilities by living off the land and perhaps building a self-sustaining log cabin. Hunter would like to thank Mrs. Lisa Anderson for the indelible impression she made as his teacher and all others who have shown their support and guidance, especially his parents and sister.
Stephen Vermeeren. Stephen has participated in Drama Fest and the Fine Arts Review. He has also taken advantage of our work experience program. He plans to travel to the Netherlands and then follow a career in the culinary arts at Northwest Community College.
Nathan Ware. Chemistry and metal shop have occupied Nathan's interest at CHSS. A combination of these two things may have been the impetus for him to pursue welding as a trade through NWCC.
Corey Wesley. Physical education was Corey's favorite subject at Charles Hayes. He participated in the work experience program, putting in many hours at Tim Hortons. For the future, Corey looks to BCIT's industrial electrical program and hopes to land a job afterward right here at home. Once settled, he would like to travel through Europe. Corey thanks his mom in particular and his dad and grandparents for inspiring him to grad.
Taryn Wesley. Taryn enjoyed many courses in the fine arts. A highlight this year was the Europe trip. She will pursue training and a career as an animator, beginning at the Vancouver Film School. She would like to thank Mrs. O'Toole and her mom. Taryn is receiving the Polyco Rupert Square Award from Stephen Tao.
Aaron Wilson. One of Aaron's favorite pastimes is playing basketball. This year, Aaron attended the Tricor Blade Runners employment program where he received a number of training certifications. He's excited to be graduating and is looking forward to employment opportunities where he can apply these new skills. Aaron would like to thank his mom and Nan for encouraging him.
Megan Wilson. Biology and participation in student leadership enhanced Megan's experience at CHSS. She has not named any particular plans for the immediate future other than working and doing some travel to gain colorful life experiences. Megan is receiving a Polyco Rupert Square bursary from Stephen Tile.
Tyler Winther. Health sciences, biology, the ACE at Millwright program, and yes, television appearances have occupied Tyler's time at Charles Hayes. He's also participated in band and rugby. Tyler plans to attend UNBC to study epidemiology. Tonight, Tyler receives a Carrick Singh Sandhu Memorial Scholarship and a Prince Rupert Lions Club Harvey Taylor Memorial Bursary from Mark Taylor, a Prince Rupert Regional Hospital Dr. R.G. Large Scholarship, and the Maureen McLean and Lothar Kinnear Bursary from Sheila Gordon Payne.
Dana Zach Stewart. Dana's particular interest has been in art, with sculpting as the genre of choice. However, another form of art is the future, the culinary arts, baking to be exact. Dana would like to thank both Ms. Parker and Mr. DeManuel for their support.
There they are.
The The class of 2014 has selected two representatives to speak on their behalf. Please welcome this year's valedictorians, Norma Apollos and Cyrus Sobredo.
Guys, we've graduated.
We've leapt over obstacles and crossed boundaries, and now we're finally here.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Before we dive into this long speech about how amazing we are, I'd like to thank everyone for sharing this memorable night with us. My name is Norma Apollos.
And I'm Cyrus Sobredo. Norma and I would like to extend our gratitude to our peers for selecting us to represent our grad class of 2014. We are truly honored to stand before you and reflect on the past 5 years of our lives.
The past 5 years of our lives. There have been ups and there have definitely been downs, but we've managed to stay true to ourselves.
I remember pulling into the parking lot and opening the front door of PR. I remember hearing the hustle and bustle of my soon-to-be classmates and just standing there not knowing what to do and where to go. I was so nervous, and being the clueless grade 8, I couldn't find where one of my classrooms were, so I ended up being late. That's when I met you.
I don't remember much about my first day of high school, but I do remember meeting you. And as you already mentioned, you were late for class. I abruptly introduced myself, and you didn't really like me. I was funny and clever and witty. What's really changed?
Yeah, I remember that, Miss Know-It-All. Although, as time passed, our friendship grew stronger, and the negativity faded away.
I'm glad that happened. High school has thrown curveballs at all of us. It has pushed us to our limits, pushed us past our limits, and it has shaped us to be the people we are today.
But that's not the only thing. In 2011, the fist and the hurricane went boom.
What Cyrus is trying to say is that there was a massive rupture in our social hierarchy.
Well, you're close. The rupture contained the dislike between both Charles Hayes and PR. All former PR students, including ourselves, were taken by the hurricane and forced to leave our home.
Like all new experiences, the amalgamation was extremely difficult. We could have perceived this new movement as a challenge or an opportunity, although given the circumstances of the time, it felt a lot like a challenge.
A challenge we embraced. Charles Hayes was different. Nevertheless, we made the best of it. We were introduced to new students and adapted well with the Charles Hayes faculty. With new environment came new experiences, which only brought us closer together.
Literally, the hallways were packed. But the atmosphere was fun. And exciting, like grade 12. Grade 12 has been stressful and tiring, and we, like many of our fellow graduates, are ready to start the next chapter of our lives.
We've all been asked those questions. What are you doing next year? Or what do you want to do in the future? It starts to build up to the point where you yourself start to wonder about the answer.
Oh yeah, those questions that make us think about our future, our transition into adulthood. I don't understand it when teachers tell us that they're preparing us for the real world. Or when parents reference things to the real world. We are living in the real world. We just happen to be in high school, and we still have time to worry about minuscule things.
It all comes down to our own aspiration on how we look at the world, and as we look onward to what lies ahead. As humans, we have a natural tendency to overthink. We live in a world where making money is more important than happiness, whereas we should enjoy the ride and see where life takes us, ensuring we are thankful for what has brought us to where we are.
That's not the only thing that has brought us here. We would like to exaggerate our appreciation to everyone that has helped us. Through all of our hardships, our challenges, and frustrations, thank you for being here. Thank you for holding on to us and believing in us when we didn't believe in ourselves.
The community has had a big impact on who we all are and who we all aspire to be. We thank the community and all of its members. You are the people we look up to. You have all been in our lives helping us fundraise for community events and helping us grow as people. You've helped us develop the social skills necessary to take the next step. We'd also like to thank the school district and all of our teachers.
You have opened our minds. You have dealt with our behaviors and attitudes. You have opened our eyes to all of the possibilities that the future holds. You've given us hope and shown us that teachers are more than they appear to be. You are our parents at school. You care for us and believe in our potential. Thank you for raising us. But before you take all of the credit, we'd like to finally thank our parents.
Mothers, fathers, grandmothers, grandfathers, guardians, you are phenomenal. Thank you for dedicating your lives to us, for subsiding your feelings and time to raise us to be who we are today.
While contemplating on which quote would exemplify our class, Cyrus and I came to the realization that our class isn't an ordinary grad class. Our class is full of unique people. We are the doers, the dreamers, and the determinate students that see one another in the same light.
Our class cannot be labeled. We are not your stereotypical high school students. There are no jocks, no nerds, no punks, and no super free-spirited hippies. We all appreciate each other's individuality and accept each other's differences. We are a group of young individuals waiting to take the next step in our lives, making sure each step is worthwhile.
We've learned as we've gotten older that rules were made to be broken. We've been bold enough to live on our own terms, and we've never, ever apologized for it. We've gone against the grain, and we've refused to conform. We've taken the road less traveled instead of the well-beaten path. We've laughed in the face of adversity, and we've leapt before we've looked. We've danced as though everybody was watching, and we've marched to the beat of our own drums. And stubbornly, we've refused to fit in.
The most important kind of freedom is to be what we really are. We trade in our reality for a role. We trade in our sense for an act. We give up our ability to feel and in exchange put on a mask. There can't be any large-scale revolution until there's a personal revolution on an individual level. It's got to happen inside first.
And it has. We'd like to thank our grad class for letting us be who we are and for allowing us and every one of us to express ourselves in our own way. These past 5 years have been the best.
And the worst.
5 years of our lives.
We greatly appreciate all that we've become.
So thank you on behalf of the graduates of 2014.
Thank you, Norma and Cyrus, for those words of wisdom. The grads have two last presentations to make. For those, I will call Marcus Comodina and Jenny Nguyen to make their way to the podium.
Hi, everyone. I'm Jenny Nguyen.
And I'm Marcus Comodina. Each year, the graduating class would like to donate a portion of our fundraising to the next year to help them get them started. This year, we will like to give it to Bronwyn Carberry.
The grade 12 students have chosen Backpacks of Hope as this year's community gift. Marcus Comodina will present to Captain Gary Shields of the Salvation Army.
Thank you, Marcus and Jenny. At this point, I'd like to invite the RCMP to take their places in front of the stage. While they're making their way down for the recessional, a quick reminder that everyone is welcome and encouraged to take photos in the lobby after the ceremony. But remember, grads, return the sashes and gowns to the green room before you leave the building. We'd also like to acknowledge the many people whose hard work and dedication have helped make tonight's ceremony possible. And we thank you for sharing in the 2014 commencement ceremony with us. Enjoy the rest of your family celebrations and please drive carefully. Well, we've come to the end. Now's the time to grant our new graduates the honor of first exit, followed by the RCMP Honor Guard. Please remain in your seats as they make their way out to the lobby. Ladies and gentlemen, the recessional of Charles Hay Secondary School's class of 2014.
So this is what you meant.
to you yet to unfold. Pretending to be who you're not is a waste of what you got. Keep dreaming, keep dreaming, keep dreaming, keep on, keep believing.
We are the kings and queens, our hearts they break when we fall in between the cracks. Living life like it's just a game of blackjack. I don't know how, but we always find our way back. Looking back when I was just a little girl with a big dream, living in a lonely world. It seems life is impossible, so believe that you're unstoppable. Hey,
we are stars and we are open-hearted. We are lovers, we are into loving. We are stars and we are open-hearted. We are lovers, we are built for loving. Oh, 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 oh.
It's hard to see the light when you're caught up in your life. You're scared and insecure, cause now it's fight or flight. Can't think of giving up, you don't know how much you love. Keep dreaming, keep dreaming, keep dreaming, keep on, keep believing.
We are the kings and queens, our hearts they break when we fall in between the cracks. Living life like it's just a game of blackjack. I don't know how, but we always find our way back. Looking back when I was just a little girl with a big dream, living in a lonely world. It seems life is impossible, so believe that you're unstoppable. Hey,
we are stars and we are open-hearted. We are lovers, we are into loving. We are stars and we are open-hearted. We are lovers, we are built for loving. Oh, 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 oh. Reflecting now on way by finding what was real. Now the days are so long, that summer's moving on.
Just wanna see you be brave.
see the fall. Hope when the water rises, you built a wall. Hope when the crowd screams out, you're screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay. Hope that you fall in love and it hurts so bad. When the moment comes, you'll say, I live. Hope that you spend your days, but they all add up. And when that sun goes down, hope you raise your cup. Oh, I wish that I could witness all your joy and all your pain. But until my moment comes, I'll say,